So my session is about the new paradigms in machine learning. Okay, so this conference is about MLDS. So the talk is all about machine learning 4.0. This is what I have named the topic, from computational intelligence to quantum intelligence. So what's happening is, I mean, you'll find that over the last few years, there has been a confluence of different kind of algorithms, mainly coming from mathematics, and the systems which have evolved over the time. They're basically means of crunching a lot of data and probably giving some insights, which to buy some metrics, they are useful. But here we are talking about intelligent machines, the machines which probably will augment a lot of human lives in the future. So the kind of algorithms which we are seeing right now, that will go into a bottleneck after a certain point of time. So here in that particular talk, what I'm going to tell about is how this breeds of algorithm, which have been there, I mean, which are things evolved from the natural systems, things like how the humans think, that has actually spawned AI. But things like how the ants work, like ant colony optimization, how these particle swarms work, and how collectively they can solve big problems. That is what we'll be talking about. And then it will end with this quantum intelligence, which is that Google has recently cracked probably the code for the quantum computing. How this quantum computing will change the face of machine learning altogether. That is where it will conclude. See, fundamentally, so this machine learning, I think it's quite abused word, which has been used out there in the industry. What this things like quantum computing will do is probably it will make computing more natural, more human. It will help these computers to think and evaluate in the way in which humans take decision. And the algorithms which should be created, which should solve this particular paradigm or the problems, should be more aligned to these quantum pieces. That's what the quantum computing is going to do. That's what I'm hopeful about. It's still a long way to go. I think it will take at least another decade for these things to come up. But I'm quite hopeful that it will change a lot of things around. Lot of this abusing of this AI, machine learning, will probably narrow down to this computational intelligence. See, already, I mean, if you see the talks, what these algorithms, these systems, they're doing is they're pushing the limits of struggling with the data. So there are some metrics which have been created, and what these algorithms are trying to do is work on more data and trying to improve on those metrics. But again, see, we as human, when we learn, so whatever we have learned in the childhood, what we do is that learning only we probably fine-tune over the period of time. But these machines, what has been done is every new data point is a new information to them. And again, one of the speakers, he was saying that you give a picture of a bus, you change some of the bits and pieces of the pixels, the machine thinks it's not a bus anymore. That's not proper learning. And with lot of data processing, what will happen is obviously some of these big tech companies, big tech stacks, will get generated, newer systems will come, newer technology will come. But the point of having really intelligent machines will still be far away from it. So that's what I think will happen with quantum computing. So if you talk of the traditional analytics, which most of these companies they started doing, I think that was more of a something called a decision support system. Okay, I as an expert from the data, whatever I could process with my human mind, I have taken some decision. I was just checking that whether my decision was something which the machine also supports. And obviously with things having like beautiful graphs, charts, obviously that helps people tell a wonderful business story. But with things like this, Google's DeepMind, all those things. See, I can tell you something, that we have some natural intelligence, but the other specialization that we have, like a doctor is having some specialization, a surgeon is having specialization, that comes more and more from crunching out examples, experiencing it over and over again. That is something which the human have some kind of a limitation. And that is where these machines, they excel. You can give a lot of examples to them, and in the process, sometimes they outperform or overperform the human brain as well. But again, it's just for the experience part. If there's something to do with innovation, out of the box thinking, unfortunately machines, till date, they can't do that. So those are probably some of the areas where this newer paradigms of machine learning will take us. So that's a question which as an academician I hear from the students day in, day out, that yeah, what to learn, how much to learn. So I mean, my advice to the student community, to anyone who wants to enter this field, will be that get your fundamentals right. The fundamentals doesn't change. Whatever new things are coming in, it's only building upon the fundamentals. Algorithms changes, technologies changes, but as long as your fundamentals are right, you can actually learn any algorithm, any technology. That should not be quite difficult for you to grasp. That is my advice to the people. So, I mean, that's very difficult for me to answer. But personally, I have been a supporter of this women in technology, or I've actually encouraged this women to come up, to participate more in this field. But I frankly don't have any answer to give you at this point of time for that how to bring it up. I think it's more of encouragement, more of having platforms for them, forums for them, where they can probably interact more. That's probably a nice way of starting. See, when we talk about this artificial intelligence, it's always artificial. The real intelligence is here. Okay, so the people who are creating those algorithms, the kind of data from which the algorithm is being created, if the data is depicting that there was some kind of a bias, obviously the artificial intelligence will also learn like that. So I think it's a bitter truth which is coming out from AI, this discrimination. Because inherently the people who designed it, or the data which was used to design, that was biased. That was the problem. This is the first time, so I have come to Cypher in many versions earlier. First time I'm coming to MLDS, so I'm more of a business person, but it's a shift towards the technology. I'm enjoying it, and I see a lot of young people coming out here, so I think it's a good forum for them. I think you should have more forums like this, and obviously get people from the colleges more involved in this kind of seminars.